In this video, we address digital academic content tools. Digital academic content tools consist of software, applications, programs, or websites that offer academic content resources and engage students in activities to learn academic content or skills. This includes, but is not limited to, language and literacy content or skills. We can divide them in three groups. Designed learning activities. References and resources. And finally, language resource tools. The designed learning activities consist of following elements. First, we have interactive tutorials or lessons that guide students in learning and demonstrating new content or skills, such as an interactive lesson on the life cycle of a butterfly or a math tutorial on fractions. Second, we have the practice and assessment tools that provide activities to review concepts and skills, such as a math application that provides multiple opportunities to practice addition skills. Next, we have the dynamic modeling or simulation tools, such as a physics simulation that lets students manipulate virtual equipment, change parameters, and see the results. Finally, we have the virtual worlds that immerse a student in a fully interactive environment, such as the one that allows a student to roam in a period of past history or explore a desert environment. The references and resources consist of following elements. First, there are the dictionaries, encyclopedias, ebooks, topic blogs, and topic-focused websites that serve as information resources. A good example is an online encyclopedia that offers students pictures, facts, and videos about mammals, or a digital dictionary. Secondly, there are the visual and auditory topic-related resources, such as a YouTube video on earthquakes and plate tectonics. Finally, we have the language resource tools. There we find translation tools that assist students by providing a translation to another language. There are also articulation tools that assist a student to accurate production of a language, by showing images of how a sound should be produced and by letting a student record and listen to their own voice to compare with the model.